Hi guys, welcome back to our IPPT series. Today, we're going to talk about how to train for the 2.4, specifically how to draft a training plan, the rationale for each type of training, and what to look out for. This is so that you can ace your IPPT, get monetary rewards by doing the least amount of work. There'll be two more parts to this video. In the second part, we'll talk about strength and conditioning, and in the third part, pacing. Everything will also be available in an article format, and the links in the description below. If you're new here, we have already done a video on the push-up segment. I'll put our IPPT playlist somewhere on the screen if you're watching on YouTube. There will also be YouTube timestamps so that you can skip around. And this entire IPPT feature is part of a larger series called Sports Science Simplified. One last special announcement before we start. Our team will be putting up similar online courses on our all-in web app. For those who are interested, go sign up for a free account. You'll not only get to try your IPPT virtual trainer for free, but also when we release the online courses, you'll get early bird discounts. Intro video on allin.co for more information. If this is the first time you're watching our video, this is Jing Zhi, founder of Allset, a physio and personal training company. Let's get into it. To understand how to train for the 2.4, you need to know just a little bit more about energy systems. There are three different types, and to make things easier, I'm going to pull out a table from my athletic coaching course. As you can see, you have an energy system for shorter distances like the 30m and 60m. It's called the ATP-CP system, and it's an anaerobic system. This simply means it doesn't utilize oxygen. What it does is provide a large amount of energy over a short period of time. In the 2.4, which is in between the 1.5k and 3km distances, you most likely won't be using much of it, except if you're going for a finishing kick. The other energy system that doesn't utilize oxygen is the anaerobic lactate system. It plays a major part in distances like 200m and 400m, and smaller parts in distances like 1.5 and 3km. However, as you can see, it's still significant enough for us to work on it when training for the 2.4. Lastly, we have the aerobic energy system, which utilizes oxygen to produce energy. It's the main energy system you use for anything above 400m, including 2.4. Now, to be clear, these figures will vary for each individual, although they won't be too far off. For example, these are the figures according to a study in 2005 for males and females, and another study in 1999 also showed similar figures. Now that you know about energy systems, it's time to know about the aerobic and anaerobic thresholds so that you can start drafting your own run workouts. Loosely put, these thresholds are critical points for your body's energy systems. Beyond the aerobic threshold, you start utilizing your anaerobic system. And beyond the anaerobic threshold, your body produces lactic acid faster than it can be cleared, making it hard to sustain the effort. From this graph, we can visualize 5 ways run workouts help you improve your 2.4. The first way is to improve your aerobic threshold so that even when you run faster, you're still relying mostly on oxygen and the aerobic energy system. Secondly, you can also improve your anaerobic threshold so that you won't be limited by lactic acid so quickly. The third way is to increase your VO2 max, which is the maximum oxygen your body can use. And the fourth way is to increase your anaerobic capacity, which loosely translates to how much energy you can produce without oxygen. Lastly, you can work on your neuromuscular conditioning, which you can use to improve finishing kick as well as your running form. I'll now go through some of the corresponding run workouts that improve your 2.4 in these 5 ways, but to be clear, there are many other types of run workouts that serve the same purposes. As you can see, the list is quite extensive, and so I'll cover each type of run and what they do in a future video. If you're interested, simply subscribe to the channel. For now, we're going to focus on easy runs, tempo runs, VO2 max intervals, anaerobic capacity intervals, and strides. Easy runs help you increase the efficiency of your aerobic system, which is the main energy system used in your 2.4. Specifically, by doing easy runs, you increase the following. Knowing this won't help you run a faster 2.4, so I won't go deeper into it. The important thing here is that easy runs are the foundation of a faster 2.4 because it trains your aerobic system. Hence, you'll be the most common workout on your training program. As for the pace of your easy runs, the most practical advice is to keep it conversational. If you find yourself catching your breath in between sentences, you're going too fast. Tempo runs are meant to improve your anaerobic threshold, and as a quick recap, this is a point whereby your body can still clear lactic acid faster than you produce it. Hence, for such runs, you'll be training near your anaerobic threshold pace. Typically, these runs are done for 20 to 30 minutes at your 10km race pace, and they should be comfortably hard. It can be tricky to get the pacing for these runs correct, so we'll deep dive into pacing later in the IPPT series. For now, the practical guide is that if you feel a burning sensation caused by lactic acid buildup, you're getting the pace right. And if you find yourself slowing down throughout the run, you started off too fast. The good thing is, eventually, with enough practice, your pacing will improve. As the name suggests, these workouts are meant to improve your VO2 max, and are typically done at your VO2 max pace, which is also around your 2.4 pace. The goal here is to be at your 2.4 pace for as long as possible, taking breaks in between. For the purpose of the 2.4, each set can be anywhere between 300 meters and 1.2 km. And for the rest in between reps, jog for half the distance or the same amount of time you ran for. For example, if you're running 3 times 800 meters, your rest in between each set can be a 400 meter jog. Ultimately, when you become really experienced, you can shorten the rest, but the idea of these workouts shouldn't change. You should still be running at your VO2 max pace. For anaerobic capacity intervals, you'll be running near your top speed to flood your system with lactic acid, followed by a long recovery jog. This is to allow your body to clear the lactic acid before going again. The goal here is to improve your leg strength and ability to buffer lactic acid, allowing you to sprint longer. These intervals last only 100 to 400 meters, and it's recommended that you take 1 to 2 times the distance of the repeat as a recovery jog before you start the next set. For example, if you're running sets of 200 meters, you would jog 200 meters to 400 meters before beginning the next one. Last but not least is your strides, which can be anywhere between 50 meters to 200 meters. The goal here is to maintain good form while running at near maximum pace, and eventually, things like your coordination, cadence, and step length will translate over to your longer runs, helping you maintain a faster pace without as much effort. Although these runs are done near maximum pace, it shouldn't be so fast that lactic acid builds up during the strides. This is because it will impede the neuromuscular adaptations that you're looking for, making it counterproductive. Therefore, make sure you jog or even walk for 30 seconds to a minute in between the sets. For example, you can do sets of 150 meters by going 50 meter easy, 50 meter moderate, and then 50 meter hard, and then walk back to the starting point. Throughout the entire 100 meter 50 stride, focus on cues like running tall, swinging your arms back, etc. Now that we have understood the basics, it's time to design a simple training program. Just like in a push-up video, I'm going to present the guidelines. This is so that you can understand the principles and come up with your own sets. Once again, we'll be periodizing our workouts, where one block of training means 3 weeks of loading, followed by a week of deloading. This is to allow your body and mind to recover, absorb the training, and be more prepared for the next block. Each week of loading is 10 to 20% more effort, depending on how much you can handle, as well as how you're structuring your program. If you're doing multiple blocks of 12 weeks to train for IPPT, it's also good to take a slightly longer rest after every 12-week block. As mentioned earlier, easy runs are the foundation of your 2.4 training, and so on our draft training plan, you're first going to insert the easy runs. If you can squeeze out the time, aim to do 3 or 5 of these each week. You can either vary the distances or keep them similar. One of your easy runs should also be 1.5 to 2 times longer than the others, and the purpose of that is to build endurance. Specifically, we want to increase your legs' resistance to fatigue. That way, you can handle the higher load that comes with your faster workouts. For example, if you're doing 3 km for all your easy runs, make one of these easy runs 5 to 6 km. Eventually, once you're able to hit 1 hour of easy run, you should be able to handle all the faster workouts for your 2.4 training. At this point, I'd just like to caution that it's important to load progressively, especially if you're starting from scratch and if you're overweight. Multiple researchers have shown that if you belong to these categories, you have higher risk of injuries compared to non-overweight or more experienced runners. A practical tip here would be to keep working on weight management and complement your run training with strength and conditioning, which we'll cover in the next IPPT video. Once you're able to hit around 1 hour for your longest easy run, or whenever appropriate, replace one of these easy runs with one of the following session type: tempo run, VO2 intervals, or anaerobic capacity intervals. It really depends on which area you need to work on and how you prefer to structure your training. For example, you can alternate between each type of sessions for 3 weeks and then pick a random session for your deload week. Or you can choose to do VO2 max intervals for 8 weeks and then tempo runs when it's closer to IPPT, omitting anaerobic capacity intervals altogether. The other way is that you can ignore everything else and just focus on VO2 max intervals. In terms of prioritizing these sessions, it's different for everyone. But for most people, the tempo run and VO2 max intervals will translate into greater 2.4 timing improvements than the anaerobic capacity intervals. This is simply because 2.4 utilizes more of your aerobic system than anaerobic system, as seen in the table shown earlier. Just a quick note, if you wish to start tempo runs or intervals before you're able to handle 1 hour of easy run, make sure you work your way up progressively. For example, when conditioned, you might start off with 4 times 800 meters for your VO2 max intervals. But if you're not, you might want to start off with sets of 300 meters. One more tip will be to make sure you have enough rest before and after your tougher workouts. This means you should not plan your longest easy runs on back-to-back days with the tempo runs or intervals. Otherwise, there'll be a higher risk of overuse injury. As for how to insert strides into this plan, you can either do it before the intervals as part of your warm-up or at the end of your easy runs. This is related to strength conditioning, and we'll cover it more in depth later in the series. Last but not least, you can insert time trials at the start or at the end of each 4-week block, replacing them with the tempo runs or intervals. These trials are useful in helping you track progress, as well as calculating your training and 2.4 pace, which we'll talk about in part 3 of this video. Likewise, we'll be adding strength and conditioning sets to this training plan in the next video, and those sessions range between 10 minutes to an hour. If we plan everything properly, you'll be spending the least amount of time not only training your 2.4, but also your push-up and sit-ups. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to put them in the comment section below. We might do a Q&A if there's demand for it. At the same time, you might have realized we simplified lots of things, like how the energy systems work, what is lactate threshold, etc. This is because it might not be relevant to most people, but for those interested, we have online courses and research summaries on those topics coming up. We'll be putting them at allwin.co, so feel free to check it out. For those looking for an online IPPT trainer, we are also working on that. If that's something that you might find useful, just sign up for a free account and give us your feedback. That's all for today. Till next time, take care.